Barbara Cramp has been dubbed the most hated woman in local British politics. Deemed too extreme for both the Conservatives and UKIP, this film charts a crucial day in her election campaign.
Well, of course I'm pro-life, but I'm pro the right kind of life.
When you get to a certain age, what use are you?
Vote Cramp, not you.
All right, could you drive, please, Maurice?
Hello.
Bienvenue chez nous.
Barbara Myra Winston Cramp lives at home with her husband of 38 years, Maurice.
Hello there. This is traditionally my area.
Maurice and I lead a very traditional lifestyle. We enjoy each other's company.
Maurice, what's that on the Leylander?
It's probably a... Oh, look, it's a... Thrush, I think. Harmless, pretty
get
harmless,
away!
Pretty harmless.
Get bird, away!
Pretty harmless birds, really.
We met at Henna Regatta. She was in a 4, I was in an 8.
This is my grandmother's clock.
Myrtle.
Yeah. Always think of her when I see that clock there. She loved time.
See, when I first met Barbara, she was playful as a puppy and had all the glamour of Dorothy L'Amour. One often considers that the years can be unyieldingly cruel. Barbara is a woman of principles. She's certainly a woman of standards. As far as I'm aware, I've never seen her in a pair of trousers. She certainly wouldn't shop after 5, finds that exceptionally coarse. And I've never seen her consume a bar snack.
In a world of instant messaging, satellite communication and social media, Barbara prefers to campaign the way she has done since her first election in 1983.
Vote Cramp.
I campaigned for a long time to have this concreted because the grass was attracting children.
Let Cramp represent you.
Not one of them British made. Isn't that disgusting? Isn't that...
Absolutely disgusting.
Not the council estate, Maurice. Is that Judith?
Judith! 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 Judith!
With the election drawing near, Barbara meets her constituents. Husband Maurice tags along.
English Brabans, you see, English Evelina.
What do you think of the Reuben apples?
Reuben, I'm not so keen on, I won't lie. Yeah. Did you know there are lemon groves in Dorsetshire?
It can be exciting at times. Quite frustrating as well. She's a spirited gal, one could say. Barbara's certainly got her hand on the tiller.
Capital punishment, I'm in favour of. Corporal punishment, cervical punishment.
Oh, I don't like the sound.
Yes, I like
well,
that.
No, and therefore it's a deterrent. If you don't like the sound of it, you won't do it.
I like your hair.
Oh, thank you.
You remind me of one of those punk rockers.
Oh. Cameron's Britain. What's her name?
It's a he, actually. It's Buster.
There we go. Isn't she lovely?
I'll take it off just for you.
Oh, good God, the ice. Come on, Maurice. Right. And you are from?
Canada.
And so you have tables. And do you have knives and forks?
Yes, we do, yes.
Being a conviction politician, Barbara is used to courting opposition.
Colin Eggs, he's not a man to be trusted at all.
I've got a diary of everything. I probably know more about Barbara Cramp than possibly she does. And I just find her abhorrent. I find every word that she says an insult.
The apex of this pivotal day, Barbara has organised a hustings for herself.
If you break the sanctity of marriage, if you allow 2 men to marry or 2 women to marry, where does it end? Women marrying dogs, children marrying Muslims. You know, I could marry a plate of chops. It's a well-known fact that council tenants have little to no taste. Red Nigel, Comrade Farage. It was used as a term of endearment. It had absolutely nothing to do with the African peoples. Of course, in my day, we didn't call them gay. We referred to them as filth dandies. Toddlers are no better than dogs.
We didn't have any children. There was complications and problems. Barbara had him terminated 3rd of May, 1987. I was going to call him Hugo, after my late father. Imagine that.
I say, as well as aborting those fetuses, we should be sterilising those parents, in case they breed like that again. Colin Eggs.
I just wanted to hear your thoughts on how your husband fits into that.
I wasn't talking about Maurice, was I?
My mother had a very traumatic birth with me. She was in labour for 97 hours, lost 2/3 of her bladder, all of her spleen, and near enough her fucking mind. Thank you very much, Colin Eggs.
Maurice is my brick. He always has been. He's not a clever man, or a practical man, or a terribly useful man. But he's my man. He's my Maurice.
This is where I relax, contemplate life's wonders and woes. And often at night, when it's, you know, a bit darker, the joie de privé, if you catch my drift. Do you live alone?
But what does Maurice think of Barbara's politics?
As far as the manifesto is concerned, I find it profoundly abhorrent.
If you vote Cramp at the forthcoming elections, I promise a commitment to sovereignty. Unification of the empire. No to immigration. And a total removal of Wednesday and Sunday trading. What's wrong? Why are you laughing, Maurice? Don't say that word. It's not supposed to say that.
It's you that's a cunt.
With the atmosphere in the hall turning sour, Barbara takes the decision to bring the meeting to a formal close.
My ideal world is the world I grew up in, you know. It's the world of bunting and trestle tables, nurses on bicycles. It's the world of milkmen. It's the world of Elgar, the sun rising over dales. And everywhere I look, I see that world being eroded.
Just drive, Maurice. Just drive.
Just drive, Maurice. Maurice, drive.
Maurice, drive. Maurice!
But it's not only Barbara's opponents who've had enough.
Maurice, drive the car! Maurice!
Can you get that bloody thing away from my balls, please? Thank you.
Maurice! 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 Maurice!
Excuse me, the one in the coat, are you still sexually active?
No.
Have you been neutered?
What?
It's Stephen and the twins, you know.
Thank you anyway, it's been, thank you.
Cheerio.
Bye.
So it is a Peterson, as I can see, it's a barrister deluxe.
No, I think it's a man of Aaron.
Do you live alone?